it's 2 pounds.
Okay. No, it's
Oh, good evening, Sue. First on. Mustafa. Oh, Julie. No. Yeah, they're indoors, is watching. That's all I have to say. Just give it a few seconds before I start. Tracy, good evening to you. Carol, an old badge. Diane, nice to see you. Some old punters here. Ronnie, quite a copy of video was good, wasn't it, Ronnie? Did the job. Lovely jubbly. Carol, oh, mother-in-law. Oh, evening. Yes, Mustafa, hope you are as well. I'm feeling okay. Yes, Tracy. Yeah, good evening, everyone. I'm repeating the night. It's Jane Jack. Same panel. I ain't gone round in circles, have you? Circling, so Ronnie. Oh, no, it's the same lot. Anyone? Come on, we need someone new before I carry on. No? Shall I go for it then? Yes, good evening. I've waited long enough. Because I say, I always put at the top of my page, wait for Pete. Oh, Lynn. Good old Lynn. Oh, I suppose you know the song already, don't you, Lynn? You're so good. But we've got to wait for that. Yes, good evening. Who am I? Yes, Dave Jenner, one of the church wardens at St. George's. I suspect most of you, well, you all do. You know who I am. Dodgy Dave, as they call me. Can't believe it. Another Friday. No, well, it's the end of the week, Friday, and another month gone. Can't believe it. It's October already. Incredible. And I'll tell you a couple of things. The weather's changed because, you know, the last 6 months has been beautiful, isn't it? We can't complain. And I've sort of worn shoes. I've worn shorts most days, even when I was away on holiday. And flip-flops most of the time, in and out. I've got a pair for out and in, or in and out. But today, I'll be honest with you, the long trousers are on, and I had to get them out earlier on. You know, the old moccasin slippers? Yeah, excuse my cheesy feet, but there you go. So, yeah, a bit of a challenge. I've even got socks on. So, yes, the old weather's changed a bit, but we can't complain, can we? So, there you go. So, yes, nice rainy day. Yeah, good for the flowers. And I've heard the weekend, unfortunately, is not meant to be the world's greatest, but we can only hope. There you go. I want to quickly show you something, and I had to have a laugh at this. It's on my phone. I do apologise. I'll be with you in a second. I am still here. And hold on 2 seconds. Bear with me. Saved. And it was a bit of a joke. And it says, with all these COVID and all the tests, which is not nice, but it says, warning, do not let them take your temperature when you enter a supermarket store. It's a scam. They are erasing your memory. I went in for bread and milk and came out with 6 bottles of wine. I bet there's a few of you have done that in the past, yeah? And we always do that. Forget what we're going for, but that was incredible. So, a bit sort of theme for the night. You always get it. We call them, I suppose, unexpected gifts that, that's a surprise. Oh, I didn't expect that great saying. Good evening, Sharon. Good evening, Sulu. Nice to see you. Janet. Yes, that's lovely. I'm wearing wearing two, really. I'll be taking this off in a minute, so don't all faint. This is a lovely fleecy top. That Rebecca, my daughter, she was last week at work. She had to go to Leamington Spa. I suppose it's full time to Royal Leamington Spa, I think it's officially called. And because some of you might know, she works for Mountain Warehouse, the old outdoor place. And she bought me this lovely fleece, which and because the weather's changed, I think I had it on last night, but it's not too thick, it's lovely, even indoors. So there you go. And then, completely unexpected as well, this week, I've got to show it. I do apologise to anyone. Excuse me. I'll try and not completely show my, yeah, I lost. There you go. Sue will like this. Pass this to Rebecca Productions. Yes, it's the new Spurs shirt. Matthew surprised me, absolutely surprised me, like Rebecca did on Monday. He said to Jane, I was at home, and said, oh, there's going to be a parcel. And he's bought the green one, and he bought me this, which is incredible, because I know they're not cheap, you know. And so I do apologise. We've had a good week this week. Old Carol's on. She knows it, doesn't she? Yeah, good old Carol. So tell Colin. Colin is watching. So I do apologise to our other friends from the other side of London and South London. We beat them the other night on penalties. But that's enough about the football. But, yeah, it's unexpected gifts. And if you've ever had unexpected gifts, please put them on the comments. You was, oh, blimey, that was fantastic. I didn't expect that. And there's a couple of things that has been this week. And now, the last of the unexpected gifts. Unbelievable. A little story, but I will bear with me and I will show you, talk to you how it is. Yeah, it goes back a year ago. I live in Enfield Council. We had a letter about a year ago, October 2019. And those who live in Enfield, who have in the past, you've got your local councils, all our bins have gone fortnightly, where they used to collect them every week. You get a black one for your general waste, your blue one for your recycling, and if you keep your green for your gardening, and a little one for your white food waste. Different areas, I mean, you'll have loads of different coloured bins, etc, etc. And our blue one originally was 140 litre, but if you wanted to, you could have one for free, 240 litres. So there I did. I went online a year ago, ordered my bin, got a reply saying, yes, we will be in touch very soon. Well, nothing happened, did it? So somehow it was put to the, you know, on the back burner. So I think, February this year, thought, why not? I'll go again. So there I am, typing away, get a reply, nothing happens. I bet we've all been in the same boat. And, I tried again last week. Went online, had a lovely reply. No, nothing's happened. So in the end, I found this letter, because it is from October 2019. It's got the resident where I live. And I found it in a drawer, and there's a phone number. So I rang the phone number, and you know what it's like when you ring everyone. Press one for this, press two for that, and they go through all the messages. If you want this, do this. So eventually, after 15 minutes on the phone, I must admit, a very nice lady. Enfield Council, and I said, I don't know if you can help me. And I'm told her where I live. You have to give your postcode, etc. And I said, I've been looking for the bigger blue bin. And I said, I have my letter. I said, I've got it here. And, I said, it's been taken a year. She said, well, I do apologise. She said, they were free then. They're not free now. She said, but I don't know how much it would be. So I said, well, let me know. So she took my mobile number, home number. And, that was it. I think that was Monday or Tuesday. I'll show you another picture in a minute. About 6 o'clock this morning, you know, dark mornings now, unfortunately. And I think Jane nudged me. She said, Dave, she's a bit of bashing and crashing outside. What's going on? So I rubbed my eyes, curtain, and there's a little van with one of the, you know, the bit on the back, I don't know, you know, the lift that goes up and down. And this guy's pushing a blue bin into our front garden. I thought, result, there you go. Be nice to get a call, because we've still got our old blue bin, but that's neither here or there. So I thought, oh yeah, great, that looks the bigger one. Went back to bed. So got up later, obviously. And Jane said, oh yeah, it's the new blue bin. So later on, me and Matthew he was around today, and we went to a lovely, exciting on a Friday, went to Tesco to do the shopping up at people who know it, Brookfield Farm. So I went outside and I thought, this bin looks blooming big. And one of our next door, couple of houses, they've got the bigger blue bin, the 240 litre. Now, and I've worked it out. This is the super duper one, 360 litres. It is ginormous. Well, 360 litres. Incredible. I can't really complain, can I? But we've got a side gate alley and comes into our garden. Well, when I come home from Tesco's, it was still raining. I must admit, I did struggle to get it in. But I'll show you a quick picture, if you can see it on the screen. I've put this bin next to our old one. So there's a bit excuse now. I've got no excuse for recycling. And you've got to laugh. Hold on 2 seconds. Oh, here we go. Look, there it is. There's the 140, and there's the ginormous one on, well, my left or your right. And I think it must have been someone else's, because it's got 33 on it where we live, but I think it was an 8 once. But yeah, you can't see the wheels on the new one because they're round the back, they're part of the bin. Yeah, it's a bit of a super duper one. Even the handle at the front's got a grip on it, probably because it's so blooming big. So that was my third unexpected gift of the week. So has anyone, I can say it's massive. We had our bigger one straight away. Well, yeah, good evening, Sharon. Alexa, yes, I can't see you, but you know. For those who, some new names, which is lovely to see. Yes, my name's Dave and I'm the church warden. I said it earlier, the usual coming on early. So, yes, just so you know, bit different than Father Tamen, bit of a banter with me. And I'm not going to apologise for the shirt. There you go. New this week. And yeah, fingers. And I bought me tea. I haven't got a beer this week. Had a beer earlier on. We had one of those Zoom meetings for work, about 5:30, where the team I'm in, because a few of us are on furlough, some are in, and we have a bit of a get-together. Always, everyone has a beer. And I had, it's a big bottle, one of those Hell's Lagers. It's from the Camden Brewery, which I don't know if you know it, is down in Enfield on the River Lee. And I've actually worked there in their office for work, and they've got a little shop round the side. So I would recommend it, but tea tonight. I needed that because we had a Chinese takeaway tonight. Can be a bit salty, but lovely. Nice food though. So I'm looking at my notes, you know. So yeah, but yeah, got the big one and another expected gift with a difference. And can anyone else, did you always, you know, those unexpected gifts? You know, I mean, Jane says that I'm a unexpected gift. What can I say? You know, I can't say no more, can I really? But early ones for Ronnie and Lynn and Carol and others, the song tonight is a bit about a couple of themes I'm talking. So unexpected gifts and a couple of other things follow. So we'll have another look later or another whatever, get a clue to maybe. But it's within the things I'm talking about tonight, the clue of the song. So get your thinking caps on. Dave, I like that. Jane's put, be able to do the recycling for our road. Yes, that's probably true. It is, yes. And something else has happened this week to me, which was totally unexpected. And not a gift, but it was a nice day, which I suppose if you go out with your family, or unfortunately we can't at the moment, go to the theatre, etc. It's a gift that you might get for your birthday or something else, you know. So yes, on Monday, this Monday just gone, totally unexpected. I had a phone call on the Friday from my fellow church warden, Mark Dowsett, saying, oh, could I drive a van for, he works for GP Garden Services, if you know them, and they're local to Cruise Hill. Could I drive one of their vans for them? You know, they've got a job to do. I said, yeah, no problem. So be at the yard, 8:00 Monday morning. So there I was, 8:00 sharp. And basically, I found out a bit more. It was to, first of all, to go to the vineyard. Yes, the vineyard up at 40 Hall. So for those who, yeah, 40 Hall is in a nice part of Enfield. I suppose, you call it a country house. Correct me if I'm wrong, but many, many years ago, because I think it goes back to Elizabethan time, but coming a bit up, more up to date, it was owned by, yes, the Parker Bowles family. Well, they live there. Yes, and you know that name, Camilla Parker Bowles, yeah. And for those who are in scouting, our local venture, now Explorer unit, for many years is the Parker Bowles Venture Unit, which I was in. And going back to 1967, when Venture Scout started, they asked the person, could they use the name to start the venture unit? Parker Bowles, it was agreed, and the rest is history. And here we are, 2020, with the Parker Bowles Explorer Unit. So there's the name. And yes, the connection is with Camilla, etc. So yes, but I didn't know you. There's a farm up at 40 Hall, which I did know, and they work in conjunction with the local Capel Manor College, the Agriculture College. So there I did with another guy who works for GP full time, and we drove the two vans up there, went through the gates by the farm, never been in there because there's a shop, and then you've got the house. Well, that's normally out of bounds for the public. So yes, through we go, and we park up, and then the guy I was with started to explain. He's basically, there's a vineyard at 40 Hall. I mean, some of you would know, but I didn't. And not a bad size one. And Monday, as you know, well, in Enfield, was a lovely sunny day. So basically, it was the third session of us collecting the grapes that have been picked, and they make wine. They make, I'm not an expert, Chardonnay, Pinot Grigio, I don't know if I said that right, and like a sparkling wine. And we were then going to take them to this place that makes the wine down in past Tunbridge Wells, going into East Sussex. So we had a bit of a drive. So yes, they and the guy at GP had a one of those what do you call it? The drones. That's it. The drones went up taking pictures for the 440 Hall, because it's obviously they advertise themselves. And we picked the grapes. And it was incredible because some of the grapes were well had been eaten, and in one of the trees was it literally full of those you see them around London and out and about, those parakeets, very green, red beak. We saw some down when we were away in Broadstairs even, and and of course they come down and eat a lot of the grapes. So the amount this year wasn't as usual, and I think they said they had a bit of a frost back in May, but that didn't help the growth of the grapes. But we loaded the vans. They have to weigh them. Pictures were taken to show what was going on for GP and for 40 Hill for advertising, etc. Had a light little drop of glass of wine from 2018 harvest. And harvest, which is very apt for this time of year. And we then drove down to East Sussex. Yeah, we went past Tunbridge Wells, kept going country lanes. I saw a sign, Eastbourne, 25 miles. We arrived at the at a farm, and they had and the shutters were open. The three guys were there. This is about 4:30 now in the afternoon, and they had the vats, and the thing was doing already some from someone else, big rolling machine that does the crushes the grapes. So we had to transfer our grapes from our boxes into their boxes. So yeah, it was a lovely day out, which was unexpected for me. So there we go, another unexpected time, which was it went fantastic. And just going back, for those who don't know 40 Hall, if you live wherever you are, you might be able to see it soon. I don't know how soon. Is the Antique Roadshow that's on BBC? Is it Sunday night? With the old who's the newsreader? I can't remember her name.
Fiona Bruce.
Fiona Bruce. Thank you, Rebecca Productions. Fiona Bruce, and she said, yeah, because I think 40 Hall was meant to be on in May, but of course it never happened. But I know a couple of weeks ago, it was not open to everyone. It people only who could take their items to be, and a few others maybe. So I think soon, I don't know how soon it will be, so you'll be able to see what Forty Hall looks like if you've never seen it or been there. So that will look out for the Antique Roadshow. So yeah, it was a lovely day, totally unexpected, but very nice. Just turning my book over. And so who are we? Oh, Jan, good evening. Just saying a few hellos again. Tony Becker, yes, good evening. Louise, Alice. Oh, Alison, how are you? Madeline, nice to hear you. Or not see you, I can't, but nice for you coming on this evening. So going back to Forty Hall, I didn't know where we went, the vineyard. There's a massive farm there. There were literally, not hundreds, but loads and loads of chickens, pigs, etc, etc. I didn't know, because never been that, and I know the people at Capel Manor do, obviously the students work with the animals, and it was incredible because at the end, before we left, there was an odd tray of, I call them, not so lovely grapes, and one of the guys who was helping sort of took them over to the chickens, and unbelievable, as soon as he got to the fence, the chickens are running from everywhere, threw them over, and yeah, the grapes didn't last that long. They had a lovely afternoon tea, I suppose, and it was incredible. So yes, and it was you know, it was their harvesting, which is obviously, as we know, is this time of year. And on Sunday, you might have seen last week if you were on the online service, and it is that harvest time. And so if you're watching the service on Sunday, you'll see a lot of by the chancel steps, all the gifts, and which is fantastic. And they'll be helping. It's the London North Enfield Food Bank. So and they will be collecting on Monday. So if you do come on live on Sunday, I'll get my days right in a minute, you'll be able to be able to see that. And another bonus at the moment, it will be going on our website soon. For those who come to church or whatever, would want a copy, this month's October church magazine, full again, is out. So we're putting them out to the people who have them. And also you can collect one in church, or as soon as possible, early next week probably, it'll be on our website, so you'll be able to read it at your heart's content. So there you go. The new shield is out. So, yes, so I would like to, normally I would, we have someone come on tonight, always on a Friday and during the week, Nora, who's one of our parishioners, but we got, no, Nora won't be on tonight, so I don't know if anyone knows. She went into hospital today for a booked operation. She went in midday today, and she'd be in there for about 4 days, she said. So the church delivered a car for her yesterday, and hope she's well. The operation was, I think, is tomorrow, because she went in today. And I'm sure we can all pray for her and wish her well, and hope she's well as soon as possible. So Nora's normally on, so hope she's okay. And another thing before I do forget, my fellow church warden Irene, yes, she celebrated her 60th birthday yesterday. So I'd like to, on my behalf and everyone, a day late, but to wish her a happy birthday. She's joined the 60 Club, so she's with me. So happy birthday to you, Irene, and yes, which is a great celebration. So unfortunately, like most of us, she was doing things with her family, etc. But that's all on the back burner at the moment, like us all. But yes, happy birthday, Irene, if you're watching this or watching it later. So great. Yes, and as I spoke just recently about harvest, the school today at St George's, you all know, they had a bit of an online service. I think Father Tayman did it from a computer in the school for the children, by Father Tayman. And then they brought their gifts, which they'd collected, into church, going round a one-way system like we all do at the moment. So I've seen a picture earlier on, and the display, as I just said, in chancel steps, has got a lot bigger. So which we, as I say, you can all see on Sunday on the live streaming. So it certainly be unexpected gifts to the people who need them, which is fantastic. And as I said, on Monday morning, the North Enfield Food Bank will be collecting, and it'll be gifts to those who need them. Some people, which we do for charity at this time, will need the gifts, and there'll be lovely unexpected gifts for them, which is what we have. So, yes, any more? Oh, good evening. Oh, no, I said Carol, and yes, would you like begin receiving the church magazine? Okay. Yeah, we can get you a copy. Yeah, no problem, Sue. That'll be fine. So, any ideas on the song yet? I've spoke about unexpected gifts. I've spoken about collecting grapes from the vine, for the harvest. So, couple of words there that might have given you a clue. I'm not saying any more, and I must have a sip of my tea, so cheers. So, yes, the theme tonight has been about unexpected gifts, which I suppose in a way helps us in our Christian faith, where we can receive and give to others our gifts and use our talents, using what we can. Into our daily lives, I suppose, and through the gifts I've been looking, the gifts of the Holy Spirit, which is from the book of Isaiah, and includes what we all can have is wisdom, understanding, courage, knowledge, reverence, and the fear or the wonder and the awe of the Lord. So that is about the gifts, and you can find that in the book of Isaiah chapter 11. So, and that is where we are as people, where we like to receive gifts and also give them to us, from receiving them and giving to other people, which sometimes people say giving a gift to someone, they enjoy that more, and we can in our own daily lives. And through learning, etc., through the faith, is about helping and receiving and using the knowledge that we have in anything we can do. So, before we finish, if we can bow our heads, hold our hands for a prayer. And after that, I'll have our usual Lord's Prayer. So, let us pray. God of love and life, let us take time to look deep within ourselves and discover the gifts and talents you have blessed us with. May we take the time to direct our lives in a way that best uses our own unique combination of gifts, and may your Spirit help us discover where our own strengths and interests lie. And may our faith guide us in realising our gifts that we have. May we always be open to the direction of the Spirit and never forget the love you have for us all. And we ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So, has anyone got a clue before we move? Oh, I've got a brand new combine harvester. Well, I'll give you the biggest clue. I said on Monday I went to the vineyard at 40 Hall. And obviously we were collecting grapes from the vine. Did you hear that? Or was it, I heard it through the grapevine? There you go. And as you know, many of you will know, it's by Marvin Gaye. So yes, I know some of you, red wine, well, very good, Ronnie. But no, I've heard it through the grapevine. And yes, thanks for joining tonight. And yes, lovely Spurs shirt. So yes, that was, and I hope to speak to you next week. And if not, I will see you at Sunday at church, or on watching if you are. So all have a good weekend. Don't get too wet. And here is, I heard it through the grapevine. If my brother Martin was listening right now, one of his favourites, Tamla Motown, the Diana Ross, brother loves them, yeah. Oh, well, I'm taking everyone else, so. Right, as I said before, all have a good weekend. Don't get too wet. And yes, if you've got any gifts, use them. And lovely receiving and giving. So yeah, nice to speak to you, and I will see you next time. So have a good week. Good evening. Up Spurs.